Wow, yeah. This is different.
This is what it is now.
You on your grown and sexy, huh? Oh, All right, okay. This is
welcome to a shot discourse, y'all. It's your boy, DebtFreeDeem. And I'm just here chilling out with my girl.
It's Yas, guys.
What's up now?
Come on, you gotta stop.
Now it's
we're not doing this like this.
It's Valentine's Day, y'all. And I wanna know what day you fall on.
Oh my god.
We got the starters. Premiere day, February 14th. Clap it up for y'all. But what about the loves on the 13th? Shout out to y'all.
Woo.
What about the loves on the 12th? Another love TKO, baby. Just make sure you know where you fall on the roster. Let it go.
Wow.
Play your role, baby. Just want them to play their role.
Okay. So basically, he's telling y'all that, you know, you might not get Valentine's Day, but you still have the day before, the day after.
Just
so
appreciate
just
what you get, baby.
Just know your place.
Appreciate what you get.
Okay.
Because sometimes, some people ain't got a day at all. But I appreciate what I got. Sometimes I was the 12th. Sometimes I was the 15th. I let that love go. But now,
you are the 14th.
I'm a 14, baby.
Oh, nice.
And I won't let it go.
Yo, my co-host, this is what I have to deal with, y'all. Like,
What up?
We back.
Shout out to Discourse, man. Guess what I get to do, Playboy?
Guess what? His thing is over. Like, he can drink.
It ain't, like I said, it wasn't a,
it was just,
it wasn't a full resolution.
No, I feel like you do that. Like, I think you do it every year. Maybe a different time, but it's just something.
Yeah, we're just going to do, we did a little dry January. We did a little thing. So, I'm back, y'all. Not that.
He's back.
And through my sobriety, I've learned so much about myself that I have a temper.
Okay.
Sober temper.
Okay.
So I was working on that.
All right.
And then, like I said, the colors were coming back. Things were more vivid. Life was just lifing. You know what I mean?
Without the liquor.
But now.
Now.
Life is live,
life
baby.
Is back.
I feel good.
You back in action.
I'm smiling.
Right. You smiling from ear to ear. You came on singing. First of all, let's start there.
Come on, man. You know what it is.
That's funny.
So, let's do things right.
Yes.
It's a shot of discourse. Oh my God, feels so good. So you like the intro? Did you like the smooth?
I like the intro. You lost me. I was trying to figure out where you was going with this, and then I realized where you went with it.
And I was like, is that not true?
I guess it is. According to the world, yes, it is. You know, you have a day.
Here's Valentine's Day is a very lovely day. Right,
I feel like it's overrated.
It's a holiday that we don't need.
Yeah,
but it lets people know how you are prioritizing people's life. I remember back in the day, man, and my life is different now. I'm a family man.
Yes. Okay.
But Valentine's Day was one of the most busiest.
Yeah. I think it was. Oh my God. Mean, I don't.
It's too much.
I can't vouch for Valentine's Day because I don't really it wasn't a thing in like my relationship, like it wasn't you know, but I did get stuff, but I'm not one of them people to make a big like, oh my God,
oh, that's good,
you know,
because these celebrities will have you thinking Valentine's Day is the only day you can show love to you,
and that's what I don't like you're making it seem like that's the only day. Like, it's cool, I would love to be, you know, a Valentine and do all of those things, but at the same time, like, when you're in a relationship, I feel like love is, it should be something that's not just a one day type of thing.
Yeah.
It's just something for people to do. But I make sure, like, for my daughter, you know, I make sure I go out and do stuff for her.
That's nice.
And make sure, I just had a conversation with her dad. I was like, you know, he's not big on Valentine's Day, but he's like, he buys her stuff, flowers and stuff to be around. But I'm like, you haven't done it in a while. Valentine's Day is coming.
Yeah.
Just even though I know that you don't really care for the holiday, but for her, she might not, because you haven't bought her flowers in a long time, just buy her something.
So what is Valentine's Day then in a woman's eyes? Like, so this is what you're here for, yeah. You're supposed to
yes. break this. I mean, in a woman's eyes, it's a day for you to shower them with love.
So what about birthdays?
That's just another day. That's another day you add to, that's another day that you add to it. But for women, Valentine's matter of fact, let me take that back. Not all women. Some women, they want to shower. Other women may want to shower their man. It's a day of love. So it's a lover's day. So sometimes.
You're not about to get into this early. You really think that Valentine's Day is for men?
No. Okay. I didn't say. I know that it's not for men. I know that it's not for you guys because y'all could care to give two shits about it. No. But
it's not about that. Nobody gives us anything for Valentine's Day.
That's a lie.
This is a female holiday. What are you talking about?
No, it's not. Y'all make it. It's not a female. It's a day of love. It's a lover's holiday. Don't y'all love? Niggas love too.
We're going to put this in a poll. Okay. I want to know how many.
Here we go.
Women go and give gifts to their men on Valentine's Day.
We could poll it.
And how many women go out and take their men out for a nice dinner and event on Valentine's Day?
I feel like if you're in a relationship and you guys are doing Valentine's Day, isn't that a mutual thing? Aren't y'all?
That's we ain't talking about that. We talking about when you in the jungle and you date.
They ain't about that. They ain't about to be out here buying no nigga no nothing. They probably looking for their roster to buy them stuff.
But that's what I'm talking about.
And then you have some women that are sugar mamas. You got sugar mamas out here that's going to make sure that they take care of their sugar baby.
Their little sugar cup.
Yeah. So.
Yeah, I just think that Valentine's Day historically has been for the women. Yeah. Maybe that has changed now. I haven't been out there in a long time. But most men will say they feel the pressure during that day to do something nice for the lady.
Yeah.
Get her flowers. Take her out to eat. Box of chocolates. Mm-hmm. That's just how it is.
But I also think that some men, too. You also have the men that is like, oh, it's Valentine's Day every day.
We ain't gonna talk about what type of men those are. But yes, they're all those. They're all those.
Nigga, it ain't been Valentine's Day since 1986.
Those Derek Jacksons that say.
Nigga, you ain't had a Valentine's Day since we got together, but whatever. But I think that, like I said, for me, it's nice to get something that if somebody thinks about, you know, like, oh my God, will you be my Valentine type of thing? It's cute, but it's not a requirement. Like,
yeah.
I think that's just for me because it wasn't.
Back in the day, like in school, like when I was a kid, mm-hmm. Valentine's Day, it was even more fun because like, this is back before you had to get.
Yeah,
but you know when at the time where it wasn't like, the school wasn't really on like, oh, nobody should feel left out.
Right.
And you only got like Valentine's Day from the girls that was feeling you or like you gave Valentine's to the, you know, to the girls that you liked. Man, that was cutthroat, man. If you ain't get that card or the stickers or something like that from your shorty, it was a bad time in the classroom, man.
I never got them.
It wasn't like that?
Yeah, but I'm just saying, I didn't get, it wasn't that for me.
It happened.
I promise to you. In school, it wasn't that for me.
Oh, my God.
So, you know, but I mean.
In elementary school, you ain't get no candy?
No, I don't remember getting candy in elementary. Like.
Do you just phase the stuff out of your brain?
No, what I'm saying is, like you said, where it wasn't like, I think by that time, it was more so inclusive. But I don't remember something specific where it's like, oh my God, this is just for you type of thing.
Oh, in your classrooms, you're saying that they were already on it and
everybody bringing something. If I'm not mistaken. I think that's how it was.
Even when it was like, everybody should make
you still have somebody on the side giving.
Boy,
you
I had the big card. Like, boom. Like,
I think the last time I got something was probably kindergarten. His name was Louis. His name was Louis.
Louis had a game. What'd he do?
Little Spanish boy.
What'd he do?
He gave me something extra. Like, it might have been like a teddy bear or something like that.
Oh, my God.
He was a little Spanish boy.
Yo, and let me tell y'all, man. In that time, bro, that was the most. You know how vulnerable you got to be as a kid?
As a kid.
To go to your parent and be like, hey, mom, can I?
At that age. Candy and stuff, I like this girl.
But can I get that teddy bear for Yaz? Who, Yaz? Man, it's just good.
He's so cute.
Yeah,
because when he gave it to me, my mom was like, oh my God, that's so cute. My uncle was like, nah. And I'm like.
And you ain't hold his hand not one time.
Yes, I did. He was he was my little boyfriend in kindergarten. That was my boyfriend.
Good, man.
Yeah, that was my boyfriend.
What's his name, Louis?
Louis.
Louis, man. Shout out to you, man. That's what's up, man. Yo, after what you want in life.
You got to.
That's the season. You got to. You got to bring that time
Shoot
back.
Shoot your
that,
shot. You energy. Miss 100% of the shots that you don't take.
I'm tired of DM energy. I'm tired of Facebook poke energy. Yeah.
Facebook poke was a hell of a time.
I didn't even know what that was.
I didn't realize that's what that meant.
Neither
until
did I.
I didn't know that. I thought it was just like another thing. Like, oh, poked you. Like, I didn't. Yeah, that's
I'm looking
crazy.
Like, what is this? What is this? Right, notifications. Didn't even pay attention to that.
Yeah, it's crazy.
But we got to go back to the cards, man. A little. That's why
I love cards. I'm still a person that does that. Like, I love like cards. Like, and mm-hmm. I'll write. I like little stuff like that. Like. Yeah. Instead of, you know, like, oh, send you a note. Like, I find a nice card and it says how I feel. Oh, yeah. I'm just going to buy it for you. Mm. It's not your birthday. It's not anything else. But I saw it and I thought about you.
Yeah.
Like, I like that. I need to get back to that because I lost that for a while. But I like stuff like that because it's cool.
Yeah, man. Louis did his thing, man. I really appreciate that, man. Because I was like that. I was a shooter back in the day. But
yeah.
Even in high school when I got a little money in my pocket, I would get the big cards, like the 5-foot cards.
Yeah.
And
embarrassed. I love
shorties.
Those are so cute.
Can't even
those
put in your locker. So now you gotta walk around with
right. Now you gotta walk around
straight
with
embarrassed chicks.
All right.
It was dope, man. It
yeah,
was dope.
That's funny. I think that Valentine's Day too is like for younger people too. Like you just said, high school, you remember like, oh, your boyfriend is like boyfriend or girlfriend, you going all out. You want her to have the biggest teddy bear. You want her to be seen. You want people to know, like, yeah, that's my shorty. Like And it's like, bro, I got to walk around school with this.
Yeah, but it feels
good.
It's uncomfortable. It feels good.
It's uncomfortable, but it feels good because it's like, oh, your boyfriend got you that. Yeah. Oh.
And that's what I'm saying. That's what women want. So going back to this, it ain't about the man thing. First of all, for Valentine's, for us, it's just.
But y'all stress it for no reason. Like, you don't got to be. Men stress it for no reason. It's like, yo, if
Brokey,
you know your.
Brokey McFadden stresses it for no reason.
If you know your girl.
I'm sorry, Brokey
you
McFadden.
You don't have to. Like, last year I got. A tripod and like a light to go on my phone to record.
Okay.
And flowers because I said that I wanted to start vlogging.
Good.
I said that a long time ago and wasn't expecting anything for Valentine's Day, but I got it for Valentine's Day. And I was like, oh, so you listen. Thank you. Appreciate it.
That's all it's about,
so it's simple.
Man.
Like, you
it's
don't got to go. I think women want this whole hotel room with the
pillows
and all
that.
No.
I don't even think that's the other misconception.
Maybe that's social media. Here we go.
There you go. That's the other misconception from social media and what we think that women want. Some women just...
Simple, man.
Simple, bro. Just feeling appreciated.
Right.
Send something to her job.
Yep. Asking. You know, ask me. Ask me to be Valentine.
Yeah.
Don't just assume because we together... Like, not like that, but to the cute, like, oh, will you be my Valentine? Yes or no? Mm-hmm. Like, oh, babe, that was cute.
I mean, what could be cute too? Kidnap your girl. Remember
you keep talking
time?
About kidnapping. Don't kidnap me because I'm too. I got PTSD. You kidnap me, I'm going to be ready to shoot.
You gotta watch out. All right, maybe not kidnapping, but do something special.
Yeah,
man.
I definitely agree with that.
But to me, don't go and break the bank of something you don't got. Remember that.
Work within your means.
To me, I think Valentine's Day is a day that we all know when it is.
Yes.
So you should be saving your ducats for that a little bit.
Yeah.
What do you think is like? Not enough effort during Valentine's Day, and you could just use any example. Like, what is a terrible effort?
If you don't do anything, it's terrible effort. Like, if you're one of those people that be like, "Oh, it's just another day. I love you every day."
Yeah, that's corny.
That's corny.
Yeah,
it doesn't matter whether I know that you love me every day, but it's Valentine's Day.
Usually, I'm on the fellow side, but I don't like that.
Like, why
do something?
Yeah, do something.
And for all your shorties, what?
You see how he just slid that in there, right?
Oh, you like that?
I'm for it. Go ahead, do what you got to do for all your
shorties.
But again,
that's what I'm saying. If you got it like that,
if
that's
you got
a lot
it like
of responsibility.
That, it's a lot of responsibility.
Them holidays,
yeah, exactly. Them holidays. Birthdays, Christmas, everybody got to get treated equally.
That's why you got to start an argument before Valentine's Day.
Is so that really a thing? Because I keep seeing that on social media, like. People, oh, your nigga might get, if your nigga getting weird, it's because Valentine's Day is coming.
Yeah,
or if
usually
your girl,
around January 25th. You got to get your argument in January.
How about y'all get new niggas? How about that? Get new niggas because
we've real subtle with it.
That's no, you could tell.
Real subtle with it.
It ain't real subtle.
it's a 2 year thing that like you could probably get that off two times, but third time you either that broke, don't even you make either sense. Broke up and moved on.
Yeah,
but you can get it off two times.
Nah, we not. That's corny.
You don't know it till it happens.
Yeah, but y'all corny for doing that. Y'all corny for doing that. That's lame. That's lame nigga energy.
You know how many roses that is?
I don't care. You're the one that stayed here trying to play the field. So don't make them all feel special that they need to have something for Valentine's Day.
Sometimes they don't have nobody, y'all.
Okay, and that's why you trying to be the captain save a hoe.
Or, why you gotta be hoes?
Listen.
These are good quality people. That's,
okay, so if they're good quality people, why are you juggling all of them?
Not juggling. Trying to build an experience. That's it.
Nah.
So just because, look, think about it. There's somebody right now looking at Valentine's Day and don't got nothing. So why can't someone come and help them?
They can come and help them. They can absolutely, if they feel like that's what they want to do. But why do you feel the need to help somebody? Why do you feel the need to do the damsel in distress thing?
Because
what?
My brain and Disney movies, the trauma of watching that social stuff. Media. I want to save her.
No, but you don't really want to save her.
I do.
No, you don't. Because
there's some girls you just argue with on the 20th. On the 25th.
So which one do you do? Which one do you argue with?
You got two. You got two.
Two.
And game right here. This is a perfect weekend, right? Because now you could really like do the days where it's like Saturday, Sunday.
Well, you can't really Super Bowl a Sunday.
Exactly. It's so much going on. Like you could just deviate, shift around, and then nobody's really going to want to celebrate on Monday.
But it's Valentine's Day. So that one that you give Valentine's Day to, how are you going to decipher?
I'm at work.
You don't work all night.
I'm at work.
You don't work all night.
We got a real busy presentation.
Now niggas is lying. this niggas is lying.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Not you. I'm not saying no.
Whoa.
No, not him. I'm just saying niggas. He's not in the niggas. I'm just saying now niggas is lying.
Amen.
If you're going to do all that, just don't worry about Valentine's Day. Like, just don't even participate.
Okay. That's really crazy for you to say, right?
Why?
Because they're homeless people in America, right?
Really?
There's people that are starving and hungry, and there's organizations that are out here feeding and sheltering these people. So when you have someone,
you don't have a nonprofit organization to be giving out free love. You just
that's trying to get it incorporated, but it doesn't fall in the guidelines of a nonprofit organization.
You just literally said this entire weekend you could duck and dodge, and then Monday say you got to work. So what part of the
said duck and dodge? You put duck and dodge in my mouth. We're gonna play it back. You said duck and dodge.
No,
I said.
Oh, it's a lot going on.
It's a lot going on.
Yeah, so you don't got then Monday gonna come. Nobody wants to celebrate on Monday. That's Valentine's Day.
Yeah,
and you say I got to work.
Got work.
So what part of your nonprofit are you actually doing if you're not even pumping any type of love or energy into these women that you're trying to save?
And you're wrong. I did.
When?
I did on the 11th, the 12th, and the 13th.
You can't, because the 12th and the 13th, we just said 13th is Super Bowl. Saturday before brunch. That is whatever.
Brunch.
You didn't, but that's not what you said originally.
And I gotta go to the game. Okay. Saturday is like the prime. I think Saturday would be the prime day.
I think Saturday is going to be the day for everybody because Valentine's Day is on a Monday.
Correct.
So it's either you're going to celebrate the weekend before or the weekend after.
So that's why I said in the beginning of my intro that you were hating on. That shout out to my lovers that are celebrating on the 12th. Shout out to the lovers on the 13th. Shout out to the lovers on the 14th. You know what I mean?
Yikes.
There's multiple days to do this thing.
Yikes.
Love TKO.
Oh wow, this is crazy.
Boom, boom, boom.
I do not support any of the things that he said. Like, listen, at boom, this boom, point, just don't boom, celebrate boom. It. Just don't celebrate it. If you gotta do all that duck and dodge, there's no point. It's pointless. That's just I
can't believe you're not with this multiple.
Stop letting you could do multiple whatever, but what I'm saying is if you get to the point where you like, all right, I'm about to lie and start an argument so I don't have to take care of her, then don't even do it. Don't do it. And so stop letting social media tell you that you gotta do a thing.
But then y'all women are the ones complaining on social media.
Yeah, that's probably because they must be lonely.
And they need somebody to help them out.
Yeah, but they need to love themselves. Take yourself out.
You got 364 days to love yourself.
Take, yeah, but I understand sometimes you want somebody else on that day to do whatever, but if you already were 364 days before that mm-hmm. were by yourself, what makes you think that 365th day that somebody is going to come and say, oh my God, happy Valentine's Day, here, this is for you? No. If you wasn't dating people, now if you're dating and you like, all right, you know you have this expectation, that's where you mess up. You put an expectation on somebody to do something that they're probably not going to do, and you let yourself down as a woman.
Sometimes so, you gotta let it go.
That too. Mm-mm, expect mm-mm, the things from yourself. Mm-mm, mm-mm. That's just how I feel. Like whatever.
Oh man! And it's Black History Month.
This is the shortest month. Are you
mad about that?
I mean, I'm not mad about it, but I just feel like I feel like what I am mad about is the fact that they don't talk about Black history in school. I asked my daughter. When? No, they don't talk about Black history in school.
Well, you have your daughter in the whitest.
But not even any other schools, too. They don't talk.
Don't do that.
Camden might talk about Black history. But what I'm saying is the majority of these schools, they're not. There's no. You know how we had when back then when Black History Month, every day we learned about, you know, somebody Black or something like that. And they had it, you know, in a classroom or whatever. No, she's taking world history right now.
Okay.
And they're not talking about Black history.
Okay.
So I'm like, that's a little, I feel like regardless of whether it's Black school, white school, whatever, I feel like it should be incorporated because
it is history.
It is very American much history. And I'm not talking about slavery because yeah. I feel like that's what they talk about when they talk about Black people. That's not the only thing that we were good at.
Correct.
Being slaves. No, we actually started stuff that the others took from us.
Yeah.
So, you know.
So here's my thought. Mm-hmm. I think that one, we need to stop complaining about these schools and organizations teaching Black history.
Right.
We need to take ownership in how we teach our next generation on what actually happened mm-hmm. and transpired. So that's my
yeah. My and idea. I make sure my stepfather is very much
yeah.
And he is a descendant of Dr. James Still that helped with the Underground Railroad. My stepfather nice. Wrote a book about it. He has a Dr. James Still Center, mm-hmm. you know, so he's very much into Black history. So we make sure, you know, he teaches my daughter these things, and every week she's learning something different. She's yeah. learning about Black people. So I make sure on my part, like you said, as a parent, that I'm teaching her because they're not going to do it in school.
Yeah.
But it's just like, dang, y'all teach about everything else. Y'all teach about European history. That's what the basis of world history is.
Yeah.
Why not incorporate African American history in all of history, because it's a part of the world. It's yeah. a part of what happened. So
we all know, I think we all know why they don't, man. They just want to show us as these yeah. things that came over from another land
and savages
helped build. Yeah. So yeah. we understand what they're trying to do with education. And that's yeah. why I said it's on us. It's on yeah. us to, I was thinking about this the other day, trying to just research critical race theory. And like, I don't understand what the opposition is mad about with teaching that.
Mm-hmm.
But then it is so funny just to think about like a group of white kids
yep.
in a class in like Mississippi or like West Virginia yes. sitting there learning about critical race theory, and it's just all white. Like
yep.
that's hilarious to me.
Exactly.
So I could see why like a teacher and an all white administration would be like, yo, we don't want to do this. I'm not saying they're right at all.
Right, right.
But it would be hilarious. Yeah,
I'm like, it's crazy. I'm like, really? Like, it's a month.
Correct.
You know what I'm saying? Like, it's a month out of your curriculum mm-hmm. that you're taking to talk about the good things that Black people have done. The inventors, the innovators,
yeah.
the philanthropists, mm-hmm. the people that started monuments, you know what I'm saying? Movements and the real movers and shakers, not yeah. just Martin Luther King and Malcolm X, because that's what y'all poster.
Mm-hmm.
No. Like, there's other people outside of Rosa Parks. There's other people outside of Harriet Tubman. There were people that yeah, were beside them.
I'm telling you, they ain't going to go into that.
Right, and that's now, what I'm saying. Yeah, I'm like, yeah. even for nursing, like for us, Florence Nightingale was the person that we were supposed to idolize.
Mm-hmm.
She's white.
Mm-hmm.
But little do you know, like I just found out that she supported racism.
Oh,
so
Lord.
she's not that we have a first Black woman that became a nurse, that was able to graduate nursing school and stuff like that. That's who I'm going to represent. Mm-hmm. Florence Nightingale ain't it for me.
Oh yeah,
it ain't it for me.
Sure, it was racist.
Yeah.
Damn.
And the agenda that she pushed, like she supported, you know, European, the way that they wanted to treat us Black people and just inhumane things.
Okay.
So I'm just like, I didn't know that.
but there were, we know about Florence Nightingale in school, like she is the epitome of nursing school.
Yeah.
Nah, not for me. That's not my story.
Yeah, I think here's the thing. Once again, it's a lot of our own responsibility to teach our kids. Because at the end of the day, guess what? They don't teach Mexican history.
No.
They don't teach too much of, let's just go to Irish history and how like immigrants came over here in New York and how they spread out and built their own thing. Asian history is not taught in American schools. I wonder if
when you go other places, if those things are the forefront of it. Like if you go to like an Asian country,
that's what I'm saying.
If they teach, if that's the narrative that they teach there, as opposed to
of course it would be because that's their culture.
That's their culture.
So now you come over here, like I said, if it's a room full of white kids, they're gonna learn about Ulysses Grant, Andrew Jackson, all these people that look like them. Yeah. And at the end of the day, they'll throw us a bone and be like, well, here's Malcolm X. No, Malcolm X.
Right.
Here's Martin Luther King. Here's Rosa Parks. Make y'all feel all right. Even me, like, I learned about in school, I learned it because my teacher was Spanish at the time. She taught us a story about Roberto Clemente, this famous baseball player. I'll never forget because the story, she was a dope third grade teacher.
Right.
And then she told us another story about the protest with the farmers with Cesar Chavez. And I'm like, those stories will stick with me because she gave me an exciting story to talk about.
Yeah.
I didn't really see color. I just saw people being oppressed, how they organized and fought against that stuff. Like, it's a shame that I know Roberto Clemente's baseball story just as much as I know Jackie Robinson, but that's the impact of that person that taught me that stuff. So now going back to, like, even just my daughter. Like, I was telling my wife the other day, I was like, yo, I don't want to put certain images and pictures in the room. And she's like, what do you mean? Like, I want a picture of, I believe the gentleman's name is Mansa Musa.
Yes.
Richest man, right?
Yes.
I want her to see that and then ask questions like, why is this guy in my room?
Right. Who is that?
You know, people would probably say, like, they probably want to put, like, white Jesus in the room. When you start thinking about that, that's a, I love Jesus, but that's a completely crazy thing to, like, when I start thinking about it, my daughter's waking up in the morning. Oh, thank you, white Jesus. Like,
that's what happens. Yeah,
So now, and I'm not saying I want her to worship that guy.
Right.
I just want her to question and look at stuff and have a story and be like, whoa, our people were the richest. We had this much gold. We had this much in our home country. And I want her to understand even heroes in Jamaica. You know, it's not just Bob Marley. You know, I want her to understand what Marcus Garvey went through in this country.
Wow. Yeah.
Right. And I want her to understand there's a lineage even behind Jamaican history. And we were a trade, a slave trade post.
Right.
Where, like, they distributed more black people across the United States. I want her to understand that. But I also want my daughter to get that we're more than slaves and we're more than people who were oppressed. And when you go look back at the African history, that's why I'm on the line of wanting to know, like, my ancestry.com.
I
know
they too. I want to do
that. They steal my
that.
DNA, though. I'm going to be one of those weird people. I think they take my DNA.
Bro, it's already out there. They get your DNA when you're born. What are you talking about?
You got to give me that.
They probably have that when they, I feel like when you're born, like, they,
they already got tied to my social.
We take footprints. We have a footprint. You have the parent's fingerprint. You have the placenta. Oh, so
it's already a wrap.
You have cord blood. Like, you're accepting. You already have these things when you're born. So 9 times out of 10, they already have that stuff. All
right. So I'll probably but do I
definitely,
ancestry.
But I definitely want to do that because I know that my grandfather on my dad's side is Portuguese.
Okay.
But I don't know what my grandmother was. I feel like she was either Spanish or something. Like, I don't know. And then on my mom's side, my great-grandmother was Irish. Her mom was Irish. So I'm like, I want to see what, and my mom thinks that my great-grandfather was Haitian.
Okay.
So we don't know. Okay. So, because we don't really know his family like that. So I'm like, I want to see.
You like a pot of gumbo.
Yeah, literally. Like, literally a whole month. I'm like, oh, it would be interesting to see what it is, because then I want to know, want to do research, want to know and go these places and see if I can.
Yo, that's huge. Like, even for me, I told you about it on another podcast. I don't want to go to Europe. I want to go to Africa and
me
just
too.
Be around
the culture.
Yeah. And it's, and guys, I know that it's more countries in Africa, but, like, that's why I want to do the ancestry thing to find out where my roots are
and visit, you know, there. See
Ghana,
if you can try
and go to these places and
yeah.
be like, ooh,
with, you know.
But just embrace that land and be around that. That would be crazy.
I always said that I wanted to do that nursing-wise, like missionary work. Mm-hmm. Like go over there, you know, to those places, Africa, Haiti.
Yeah.
You know, to kind of help be a nurse, to right. give aid to people. I know it's not safe. That's mm-hmm. what everybody keeps saying. Like, you know, Haiti's not safe. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's different. But I'm like, just to embrace that culture. Like, yeah. it would be nice. But, you know.
I'll tell you, man, when I went to South Africa, seeing just people that were just seeing people black, I'm like, yo, yeah. this is crazy.
It feels different.
It's different.
When everybody around you yeah. looks like you, you're like, y'all like, blacker what? Than me. Like, you start like, to feel like, dang, am I really black?
Yeah. People are running up to me like, yo, what's up? I'm like, yeah, like, oh yeah, yeah, oh hey. Yeah. What's up, man?
Right, because yeah. you're not used to that. Yeah, you're not used to that. Yeah, that's.
But like,
that's,
I think I gotta get that and understand where I'm from, man. Cause yeah, it's just like,
I want to know too.
Explain that to my daughter would be very powerful. But yeah. you know, like I said, man, it ain't up to them to teach us about our history.
It's up to
and
us.
Even if they tell us the history,
we still have to do research because I'm not one of them people that's gonna believe what you're gonna say. Like, because you're gonna force a narrative and make it whatever.
You're gonna wash it.
Exactly. You're going to whitewash it.
With bleach.
Exactly.
I didn't want to say that, but bleach it up.
That's what you're going to do, and you're going to make it fit y'all's narrative. It doesn't fit.
Correct.
It doesn't fit our narrative, so I definitely agree. Like, it's on us to teach.
So I wouldn't be Kadeem if I didn't hold you accountable for what your goal was in January. You don't got to say the amount, but how are you doing with your January goal?
I'm doing pretty good. I saved some. I literally, it was a thing for me to like actually budget, and I bought the envelopes, like okay. the Dave Ramsey envelopes. Good. So when I got paid this month, I took that check out completely mm-hmm. and just put the money in envelopes to divvy it up to see what I had left cool. to kind of start to do the rest of it. So
nice.
Yeah, I'm getting there.
Did you ever go through Financial Peace University?
No, I didn't.
All right. I
started it.
You have it though.
I don't know if I have it. I don't have access to it anymore because.
Oh, don't worry.
Yeah.
I got you.
Okay. Yeah.
I got you.
Okay. So, right. yeah.
My bad, Dave. But
it's fine. I got
the black market.
That's right. That's fine. So, yeah. I have the book. Like, I had the.
Total Money Maker.
Yeah. I had to do a book report mm-hmm. on that book. So, that was fine.
We going
to
ask.
Yeah.
We're not going to ask. As long as you just do the work.
Yeah, I did the work. But, so yes, I am saving some. And I think like I'm starting to shift to want to, the goal isn't to more like, it's to save, but now I'm like looking at, like I said, buying a house, like trying to figure that,
yeah,
trying to work that in there.
Still feeling some challenges?
Yeah.
Like what?
Yeah. Like I think it's just me. Like I'm in my way. You know what I'm saying? Like, I feel like I'm like, all right, am I ready for it? Can I do it? You know what I'm saying? Like type of thing. Like, and then not knowing where to start. Like buying a house is a big That's yeah. a big thing. Yeah. So it's like, all right, do I buy a single family house or do I buy a property? Do I want to take on that responsibility? I don't know anything about real estate. Don't know anything about any of it. So now where do I start? You get okay. what I'm saying? Like, and then it's like, all right, I'm still trying to get acclimated into my job. So I feel like I make more excuses for myself.
I'm about to tell you about
I
yourself.
Do. Yeah. yeah. I make more excuses for myself because, and I don't give myself enough grace to say, Yaj, you can do it.
Yeah.
It's fine. You can do it all. You right. know what I'm saying? Type of thing. So I'm working on that.
Yeah. I mean, look, take it one step at a time.
Yeah.
It ain't about like having to make these heavy, big decisions right now. Right. I think a lot of people do that.
I feel like I'm almost like behind because I look at my group. I love this. I love my circle. You guys motivate me, but it's at the same time, I'm like, I'm also the oldest out of us, but I feel like I'm the one that's behind. You get what I'm saying? Like,
could I ask this? Like, why is there a, I've never felt like mm-hmm. I was in front of, behind, in the middle of anybody.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like if I was in a group of friends that were millionaires,
mm-hmm.
I would just feel like, hey, because of your circumstances, you're rich.
Right.
Right. Or mm-hmm, mm-hmm. because of your background or whatever, you got to this point.
Right.
And I would love to be like that. And hopefully you guys could teach me.
Yeah.
Like, why? Where does that feeling come from of like behind and not as good or keeping up with your group?
For me, it comes from childhood. Okay. Like, that's where that comes from. That feeling of not enough type of thing. Like, or I got to do more, or I'm supposed to be here. You know what I'm saying? Like, I think that's where that comes from. And it's not that I compare, because I don't, but I just be like, sometimes I'm like, damn, like, I should probably be. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, I should probably be doing, or I could be doing this, or I should be doing that. And then I have to think to myself, like, yeah, your situation isn't like everybody else's situation.
That's what I'm about to say. Because, like, at the same token, I could be like, you have so much more depth of knowledge as being a parent.
Right.
And I would look to you for experience of being a parent. And that's not like.
Yeah. And that's why I look. That's why I look at. I also look at it with you guys. Like, I'm like, I learn from you guys, and I'm not not scared to ask questions. Like, because it's like, okay, y'all have these things, you know what I'm saying? So if I want to get a house, or I'm thinking about marriage, or I want to talk about anything, investing and all of these things, I have a group of people around me that I can go to and say, hey, this is how I'm feeling. Can you point me in the right direction? Mm-hmm. So it's never feeling like, I don't feel, we're not, it's not a competition, but it actually pushes me to want to do more.
And that's good.
Yeah,
that's good.
You guys push me to want to do more.
It should never be, I mean, that's what your friend group should be.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, your friend group should be a sounding board that you can bring ideas to, and like, there's little arguments and challenges, but then you obviously come out with a better understanding of where you want to go.
Right.
And I still got people like that I talk to, like, yo, is that the right thing? Or, you know, I still have this question on analyzing this deal, and somebody would, you know, give me game, and I'm doing hella research on different stuff like that. But
yeah.
I fall on my friends too, man. I really, you know, look at them to like, we're all going through life together.
Yes.
And there's no way I could learn everything.
Of course.
There's no way that I could go through every experience. Mm-hmm. So when they go through something, it's like, yo, let's talk and like, let's understand what happened.
Right.
Like, for example, I think my boy Hove, he had his house a way long time. He bought a fixer up, and he was like the first landlord out the group. And we didn't even like really notice it, or like just, you know, really understand what was going on. Mm-hmm. And then like little by little, we're learning like, yo, that's a little bit more of the wave. And then you find out the, you know, his house payment is very low, and you find out like, how he's fixing certain things. You're like, damn, I think I could do that.
Right.
And then he's telling the certain experiences. I'm like, oh, that don't sound that bad. Like,
yeah.
So, you know, next thing you know, I think my boy Patrick got a property. Mm-hmm. Orlando ended up getting a property. Lamar ended up getting a property.
Nice.
I got one. And then it's like, now, when during that whole process, everybody was asking each other questions like, yo, what was your appraisal like?
Right.
Like, how'd you
get
this thing? Or like,
yeah,
yo, the bank is asking for this explanation of this.
That's
but
dope.
It's because everybody had all these different pieces of experience. And then when you try to talk through it together.
Yeah, it makes it easier.
Yeah. It's just now, I know some people don't have these like type of groups.
Yeah.
So it's very interesting how you can try to turn that around. Or,
yeah.
Or be that person. Because I never want to be like, yo, stop being friends with these people. Like, you hear that all the time. Like,
change your circle. If they're not, blah, if they're not motivating you, or they're not doing this, then
but when people say change your circle too, it's how are you being a different, like, Hove was the different, where he did a change.
Did you introduce it to them?
Yeah,
to give them and say, oh, we can do this too.
You see?
You know what I'm saying? Like, oh, let me show you. Like, let me be the poster child right now for the group. Like, all right, yo, I'm gonna go out on a limb and I'm gonna try this, so that y'all see if it works, it works. If it doesn't, it doesn't. On to the next. But if you don't, if you're not the person to do it, then how are you gonna say change your friends? Like, you don't, you know.
And then that's like, even with so you're absolutely right. I think what people should understand is like, even that piece, don't cut friends off.
Yeah.
Just understand how you need to be more of a positive role model in the situation, so that people could be like, oh shoot, I ain't even, yo, what they doing? And like, just gravitate towards that.
And sometimes it's not about cutting them off. You also have to set boundaries, and you have to know, like, you know, if somebody is being negative to what you have going on, that's probably, you have to look at it sometimes as what they're going through.
Yeah.
It's not necessarily a personal thing to you, but they're going through something too. You could distance yourself. You know what I'm saying? Like, if it's not aligning with what you got going on, all right, cool. Like, fall back a little bit. But sometimes those people actually need you more in that moment than they need you to cut them off. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, we kind of gotta be,
We gotta find a happy medium.
Yeah, yeah, you know, exactly. You set that boundary.
There are toxic people in the world, and it's good to separate from them. But
absolutely,
you ain't doing that. Like, I think people's ego is like, bro, you're not doing nothing really popping where you gotta like.
And sometimes you're the toxic.
Off,
sometimes you're a trigger for them.
Ooch.
Sometimes you are the trigger for them to make them be the way that they are to you.
My cuppeth runneth low. May I please? She said, you is the top.
So you gotta identify that. I had to identify that. Yeah. I had to identify that within myself. You know what I'm saying? Like, I can't keep projecting. Sometimes I'm the one. Mm-hmm. And people gotta, if I bring any type of toxic anything to you or whatever, cut me off. Mm-hmm. Your peace comes first. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, so, but sometimes we have to recognize that. But like I said, for me, I appreciate that I have people in my circle to make me think different, because before, right, I wasn't, you know what I'm saying? But now I see, like, oh, I can do this. I can get this too. If they did it, I could do it. You know what I'm saying? Like, and then you push me to do it. Like, yo, you know what I'm saying? What's up? You said you wanted to do it now. Yeah. What are we doing to
and
get
no more negative self talk.
Right.
Man.
What are we doing no to get more. There? Like, no, you know what I'm saying? Let's change that. Let's get in the direction to go up, not back. Correct. You know what I'm saying? So
yeah, dope. Man.
It's dope.
I think it's just super important to identify where you fall into your group, how you can change it. And then, you know, just
it's balance, man. Everybody brings balance. Something different. Like different you say, balance. I am the oldest, but I'm also the one that had the child the longest mm-hmm. out of the friend group.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, so there's knowledge that I'm going to give when it comes to children. And I've also been through a lot of stuff.
Yeah.
So it's like, that's my part to contribute. You know what I'm saying? On top of being a go-getter, on top of being, you know what I'm saying? Being this thing, like, I could, you tell me to do something, I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna get mm-hmm. it done. You give me the directions, I'm gonna get it done. So it's like, that's the part that I bring to the table.
Right.
And then everybody else has their things that they bring to the table. Gotcha. And then it makes the group whole.
Makes the group gel.
Absolutely.
Makes the group gel. All right.
Absolutely.
So let's move on, man. I know there's something you wanted to share about Twitter's tweeting, or somebody put out a statement.
On this part of
Why she tripping?
Megan Good and her husband, the preacher guy, forgot his name.
Derrick Jackson.
That's not his name. She's not married to Derrick Jackson.
We ain't going
to
never let Derrick Jackson.
No, we're definitely not. He's never. I didn't even know who he was until that happened. But Megan Good and her now ex-husband got a divorce. Mm-hmm. And she said that she always thought that throughout her life, she felt like relationships, basically, they're going to get to a point where they're going to come. You're going to get what you need out of it, and then it's going to end. That's how she lived her life. Period.
Okay.
So like, you get what you get out of whatever relationship, friendship, whatever, and everything always has an expiration date.
Mm-hmm.
And she got backlash for that. So people were just like, so you went into your marriage saying that it was going to end, and she, but oh, on the flip,
are so dumb.
Right. On the flip side of it, she said that she didn't, once she got married to him, she didn't see that. Like, she didn't think like that. She thought that that was going to be her forever or longer than where it was. I think they were married for like 9-10 years.
Right.
But she thought it was going to last longer than that. She was like, but you know, it hurts, but you realize that it's not what it is. So I was going to say, the question that I have is that how we think? Like, do you think that everything has an expiration date? You know what I'm saying? Like, even relationship wise, like you get married and you want to marry, be with somebody, and you say, okay, I want to spend the rest of my life with this person. But does it have?
Yeah, I didn't know you were going that way with the conversation, but I'm glad you did.
Yeah.
Because I think that everything has a season.
Mm-hmm.
Friendships have a season. Sometimes you're really hot with like one friend, and then you know, out of the group of people,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
and then years, like, you gravitate to another friend, and
yes,
then like, so
that's
so
true.
Everything has its ebbs and flows and seasons. But to me, I feel like you never go into that type of situation knowing like, hey,
it's gonna end,
right? But I think people should.
Okay.
So you should always understand that, like, there are times when things will be hot and cold. There's times where we're going to be right. on and off.
Right.
And you have to be okay with that type of separation.
Mm.
So even when you get married and you take your vows, right?
Mm-hmm.
You're really not supposed to leave under any circumstances.
Right.
Richer or poor.
Death do you part.
Sicker or healthy.
Yes.
You know,
right.
Fat, bald head.
Better or worse.
Fat, bald head.
Yeah.
600 pounds.
Yeah.
I ain't describing nobody specific. Right.
But
you know, like, it's almost like we've been built to think that we're not supposed to, things are supposed to end.
But that's not the truth.
Well, let's say somebody goes on crack. My mans, I don't care what.
No
crack in the Old Testament or New Testament. Crack. Heroin. Fentanyl. None of this stuff. Meth.
Not the fentanyl.
If they touch any of them things,
You're done.
You're not my friend.
You're done.
We don't got VCRs and Blu-ray things to steal, but we got more expensive stuff.
Yeah, we got investments. We got lives. Yeah. I agree. I think that you don't go into it with the mentality.
But
that,
you have boundaries of things where it's like, yo, this is not going to work for me.
Yeah. Yeah.
You have boundaries where things you're going to say, yeah, it's not what I signed up for.
Yeah.
So even though like we have these vows or like you're like bestie for life, BFF forever. Do you understand what that means?
Right.
Like people be wilding.
Mm-hmm. I say it all the time. People wake up with different feelings every day. People wake up with different feelings every day.
And you're
day.
Not wrong for that.
Yeah, no.
And
no.
That's why I said initially when you read that statement and then I'm like backlash, that's how immature people are. They don't even understand like, bruh, my man woke up one day, he not feeling me. I'm making good. Or he woke up and he like, y'all don't even know making good. I got halitosis breath and her feet look like corn chips and she don't know how to throw it back. She got the, what if she got the iron board back? You can't deal with the iron board back, man.
But whoa, she had that when you proposed to her.
We thought it was gonna change.
Whose fault is that? That's not her fault. That's yours. Cause you thought that her iron board back was going to change and it wasn't. How was it gonna change?
I love that you walk down these deadly traps with me.
Yep, all the time.
Because
all the time.
When the roles are reversed, Yas, and women go into a situation where it's like
the nigga ain't shit. I understand that.
Who's the idiot now?
You definitely got to put the onus on yourself because the nigga wasn't shit when you met him.
So as long as it's both sides, like yeah, we're saying we're gonna keep the
yes,
same energy.
I'm keeping. You okay. Got to keep the same energy cool. For both sides. But what I'm saying is, you thought that was going to change, like her washboard of an ass was going to change. How was
not the washboard? But I'm talking about when you hitting it and she just. What's going on, shorty? Like, you gotta push your back down. Like, come on, man. Like,
yeah. Arch your back, ladies.
But
arch
like I
back.
Said, I ain't mad at making good. But like you said, like with the statement, I just feel like, yeah, things are there for a reason. And I think everybody has these boundaries where it's like, yo, we can't go into something and thinking I'm gonna move heaven and earth to make this work. That's
right.
Not how things operate in real life.
I think you touched on a good thing though. Like you said, I feel like when you talk about vows, society is we're taught that we have to do these things. So they push this narrative. So people think that, oh my God, for better or for worse, for richer or poorer, for till death do us part. But it's like that's not real.
Correct.
That's not real.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So then you add social media into the mix of exactly
crack.
I don't care what you. I'm not. I'm
your
out.
Boy start taking crack.
I'm out. You on your own.
It'd be like Stephen A. Smith. Stay off the weed.
You are on your own.
Get off the crack.
I am not. I.
Yo,
am
you
not.
Remember? Have you ever watched? It's a Tyler Perry show.
House of Pain.
Remember when the wife went on crack?
Yo, yeah. Yeah. She was out there. And he loved her through it.
Idiot.
And no, he's an idiot.
Soon as there was one scene where she was in the, he went to go get her in the house. She got the white lip. Come on, I just need. Yo, done. Done.
But at the same time,
I would have came home and be like, yo, we don't talk to her no more.
Oh, no.
We don't talk to her no more.
Yeah, nah. I mean, I get it. I get why he did it. You know, you got to have a different kind of heart.
Mama's a zombie.
Yeah.
She didn't show up for a couple seasons. Then I tuned back in. She back. She all clean.
She's clean and stuff.
She never relapsed.
That's how, you know, addiction is a crazy thing. I.
Ma'am.
Is not happening.
You'd be like, how much penises?
It's no. No, ma'am. Once you go crack, you ain't never coming back. Yeah. It's not happening.
And that's what I'm saying.
And I'm
sometimes
good.
Things gotta end.
Yeah. That moment is ending. It might be hard. You might be the father of my children and all of these things, and we might have this whole life together or whatever, but nobody's exempt.
Ain't no Bible verses on crack and meth.
Nah. And even if it was a Bible verse on it, I don't care. I'm not doing it.
Yeah.
I'm not doing it. I'm not doing it. But I think that social media society pushes this narrative that things have to be a way, and if you think outside that way, then you're wrong or you're different or whatever the case may be. But I was just like, all right, cool. The problem that I had with them was the fact that they thought it was okay to tell the world that they were getting a divorce.
Oh yeah, let's go into that now.
Yeah, like they made a statement. Oh, we decided, you know, that we're going to go our separate ways. I love him, you know, whatever. But
yeah, I don't understand these PR things.
For what?
I don't understand it.
And I mean, not to say it like that, but Megan Good, for what? Like, yeah, you're Megan Good, but you're Megan Good. So what? Who cares? Your husband is Darren. I think his name is Darren. I think he's like a maybe.
You
like,
see how we don't even know who this dude is?
I don't know.
We're immediately forgetting this
guy exists. But he does something like got her into like God and stuff like that. So I think he's like on that path.
And
but,
now she's back to the streets.
Yeah. But I'm just like, who cares?
Skeeter.
Literally. But I'm like, why do y'all feel the need to I don't care that you're getting a divorce. I don't care why you're getting a divorce. Yeah. It's sad, yes, but why do y'all feel the need to make
this? So I think it's like a publicity PR type of thing, right? Like you can't some diehard fans don't want to find out. Like if she's doing the God route, right? Or they're doing the power couple family type of thing, you know, there's gonna be fans that are like, where the baby at? Why you ain't? And then when they see Megan Good doing lingerie commercials or something like that again, they're gonna be like, oh my God, this child of God, what happened? And then they don't want that backlash. So it's good to say we're splitting up so that she can be her brand and then he could be his brand.
I mean, I get that.
You feel what I'm saying? So they don't impact each other. Because if she goes off, and I'm not saying it's wrong, but if she goes up and she does something sexy and sensual, he's going to be looked at as bad as like, why did you let your wife do that? So let's say they didn't make a statement. Mm. That's why they're doing that type of stuff.
Yeah, I get it. But I'm just like,
I don't need an announcement either.
Yeah, I don't.
Well, but I see why they do
when you talk about branding and stuff like that. But the thing about it is, do you have, why not just go to the brands that you guys have and say, hey, this is what we're doing. Why do you need to put it on social
that's
media?
That's your publicist. Your publicist is like, listen.
Well, my publicist needs to get fired. Because if you tell me that I need to do that, then you're not the publicist for me because it's not happening.
True. That's true. I think we need to get out of these people's business.
No, seriously, I don't care about their business.
Because even like, we can go take it to the max level. Kim and Kanye.
Oh, God. I'm over both of them. Please get them out there. Damn, bro. News. Please.
They everywhere. We know when the birthday is. We know who didn't invite. We know who leaked the text. We know. I'm like, bro. And it's not even like I be trying to Google these things.
It's right there.
It's just like every media outlet's on these people's junk.
It's just there.
I'm like, what's going on?
And I think it's because for the media, it generates clickbait and it generates like, they get traction. So more people start to visit, they get more to get more a big of a following and all of these things. And I guess this is where journalism has went. Journalism is no more newspapers and magazine articles. Now it's all on social media. But it's like,
but what's crazy is for our podcast, I don't want people to really, like we said this before, take the celebrity stuff with a grain of salt.
Yes, please.
You guys should not be following these people because their lives
stop idolizing are, that.
Their lives are storybooks, right? Yep. People are writing this stuff.
Yep.
There's people behind the scenes putting this together. So it's so convenient that during this whole divorce thing, right?
Mm-hmm.
Kim is going to do the SNL stuff.
Right.
You know, Kanye's working on a new album.
Mm-hmm.
You know, now it's like, we're not really focused on the religion of Kanye now. You ever notice that? And now, like, some of the music, like, he just put out Diet Coke with Pusha T. Now, say what you want about, like, oh, he ain't rapping on it, blah, blah, blah. You're still promoting a song about selling drugs.
Mm.
And you're a man of God.
Mm.
I'm confused.
Yeah. Yeah. But they're doing what sells. I just feel like when you think about Kim Kardashian, her mother monopolized off of a sex tape. Her mother monopolizes off of her children. So y'all know anything, they're going to live in social media. But I'm like, before all this, I'm like, who cares? Like, who cares?
And that's how it should be. That should be the energy.
I don't care about none of them. That should be idolize none of them.
Yeah.
I don't want to be like none of them. Mm-hmm. None of them. Not one. If you would have said a Kardashian's name and I didn't see them, I would have never known who was who, what was what. Yeah. I don't care.
But you know what's crazy? I'm trying to figure out. You know how they say, like, I don't know how an Arby's restaurant is open?
Mm-hmm.
Like, you don't know nobody that eats Arby's is like, yo, I want to go
to Arby's. But it's still open. But it's still open. People eat it.
Right? I don't know who's watching the Kardashians and making this popping. I don't know who's buying their products.
The girls are watching the Kardashians making them popping. The girls are idolizing the Kardashians. And I'm just like, so you're idolizing Kim Kardashian that came out got big because of a sex tape.
Is that wrong though?
That she did. That was trash.
Is that wrong? Might I add. Oh, you watched it?
Yeah, I saw it.
I've never seen it.
You'll be disappointed. Don't even waste your time.
I'm kidding.
That's a waste of time. I was mad that I can't get the time back that I watched. It was trash.
Yeah.
So
it's just funny to me how like I don't know how people are making full fledged porn and can't get us to the popular level as Kim Kardashian. So to me, she's doing something.
I don't know.
She's doing something genius.
I think it was a marketing thing. I really honestly believe that that's what it was. You know what I'm saying? Like that, because it was very amateur, very just trash.
Now you're critiquing her.
Yes, I'm critiquing.
I don't want you to do that.
But I'm just like,
her ride game was pretty trash. So, no,
but I'm
head game. Take it back.
But I'm saying, like, her mom was genius. She spun it.
I don't know. So you know what I don't think either? And I want people to understand this. Mm-hmm. It was never her mom.
Who spun it then?
Paris.
Hilton?
Yes.
Oh.
So remember, the whole social media thing, they got to bow down to Paris first. I'm not saying Paris put out her I don't think Paris's sex tape came out before Kim's. I don't think that's how it happened. But now, they were tight. Like, I think.
I didn't even know that.
I think they used to, like, Kim used to, like, be her personal assistant or something. Oh,
okay.
Something
okay.
like that.
Okay.
But the like moving things around, Paris is behind a lot of these people, these famous social media people.
Mm-hmm.
So now what the Master Kardashian does, the mom,
mm-hmm.
she just now has the system based on what Paris and Kim did and said, okay, we're gonna
right.
notice none of the other kids made any type of sex tape. It was mm-hmm. just like, let's utilize Kim.
Yeah.
But now what we're going to do is, okay, you're into modeling. We're going to talk about your weight loss journey.
Yep.
We're going to blah, blah. Yep. Oh, yo, Ryan Seacrest.
Now y'all got a show.
Yeah, Ryan, are you producing? Yo, let's try to get everybody on E. Bruce, you're ugly. Turn into a woman. My bad. I took it too far. When I in the brain it was right, and then when I said it, I was like, I took it too far. I'm gonna get killed. My bad. So I heard it. My bad. My bad, yo.
Yo. My bad. Wow.
When you say something embarrassing, you just go on your phone.
I cannot stop laughing.
You just go on your phone.
Oh my God. Yeah, yeah, I get it, but I just I don't care. I don't care about y'all.
Yeah.
I don't care about y'all enough to be like, in the way that Kim and Kanye are going about this, it's like, it's very distasteful because you have children. You're dragging these kids into this and you're putting it all like, this stuff doesn't go away.
Mm-hmm.
This stuff is going to be here for these kids to see. Your kids will never be able to be regular outside
of
it.
You know what they do? They're going to talk to their kids about it and be like, this is how we built what we built.
You're right, because it's publicity. This is probably what
this is. This is what I had to do so that you don't have to.
And then
do
they go, they're grow, they're raising, the kids are going to be messed up and they're going to be.
I don't know.
Because what I'm saying is, think about it. You're raising your children in the spotlight. So mm-hmm. everything that your kid does when they get older is going to be to perform, to get in a.
So how you feel about promote. Gabrielle Union, Dwayne Wade's baby?
I don't like to talk about people's kids, but.
No, I'm just saying.
I don't.
You don't got to go into detail
no,
about
no,
the kids.
Just,
but I'm saying now Northwest and. South, they're all, I don't know kids' names, but they all in the spotlight, right?
Yeah.
And I think Kanye does a good job not to put them in there. Like, I think Jay-Z and Beyonce does a good job, but you know their parents are like superstars.
Yeah.
But
Gabrielle Union.
Gabrielle Union and Dwayne Wade, they got an Instagram account for their kid.
Yeah,
they
nah, make
memes for their kid.
That's too much.
But their kid is launching a clothing line.
She could, and that's cool. She can launch a clothing line and all of those things. I just feel like putting your children out in the media the way they're savages,
yeah,
you're not protect, like there's no protection for your child. I'm not putting my child,
you're absolutely right,
in like in the spotlight like that. Like if my kid is making clothes and stuff like that, okay guys, I'm going to support the brand and do all of these things and show you, but to put my child, the fact that they're making memes of her child,
but I think they're, that's what I'm saying, I think they're doing it. Just imagine going back in time, It used to be the Olsen twins.
Yeah.
And the Olsen twins were popping because they're on TV. Mm-hmm. Full House turned them into the Disney Channel. And then you had Detective, the Olsen twins, and all this other stuff. Yeah. Them girls ain't never had to work. We don't even know if they exist right now.
And see, the thing about it, even with them, like, I loved Full House. Like, I grew up on Full House. And it was fine because you didn't see them in a bad image. Correct. Like, social media wasn't what the way it was. Now, but when they got old, when they got older and they started having their addictions, everything was out there. And it's just like, bruh, all right, now.
But what I'm saying is now, the parents' intention is just to be like, you guys are going to be good.
Right.
Financially, you're going to be good.
Right.
That's not the ill intention.
Yeah.
That's not bad.
And I mean, I get it, but I just feel like there's no discretion.
No,
and it's like they don't have, I mean, I guess they don't want to be private, but it's like you said, like when you look at Jay-Z and Beyonce, you know, they have discretion.
Yeah.
Like, cause everything is not for everybody.
Yeah, that's important.
Like, you don't have to be on public display all the time. These are still human beings, regular people. And it's like, did you ever think that your child might not want to be in a spotlight?
Yeah.
Did you ever think about that? Like to say, dang, your child is making these faces and your child feels this type of way because they don't want it.
But it's funny though, y'all. Some people be like, my kid is cute. I'm going to put him in modeling and all this stuff. And like, it's just, it is
what
it is.
And I get it. I get that. But it's like, all right, at some point.
I got you.
You get what I'm saying? Like, all right, enough is enough. Now y'all, now when it gets to the point where y'all parents is beefing like Kim and Kanye and they going back and forth. You didn't let me see my kids. You kept me from.
Well, you're rich now. You got a therapy budget.
God, this is crazy.
You got therapy.
Kanye been wildin', just period. And I mean, I just did that's just
really. Oh my god. I don't know who introduced this to you, but the fact that you can play this while we're talking now, it's just
alright, yo. It's been a shot of Discourse. Shout out to those who celebrate on the 14th, watching the Super Bowl on the 13th. Taking their girl out on the 12th. But you know what it is, man. Just love those you can love.
Oh my god.
If you got multiples, enjoy the multiples.
Oh wow, people.
Don't be by yourself.
What's wrong with being by yourself?
Don't be by yourself. Why be by yourself? Don't be a fool.
Somebody come get him, please.
Come on.
No. This is crazy, guys.
I'll holler at y'all next time. It's been a shot of Discourse. It's your boy, DebtFreeDeem.
This is, and it's your girl, Yaz. Have a good day.
Holler at y'all.